The crew enters the goldfields of Marudi, following a network of jungle trails.
You gonna talk to these guys?
Yeah, man, definitely.
There's two types of mining happening around here. It looks like there's like hard rock, which is the gold still, you know, in the rock, and placer, where it's like what we do in the Yukon, you know, free gold and gravel.
All the gold that Parker has ever mined,
we're here to make money, and we're making money,
is from placer deposits, gold found in the gravels of riverbeds. Hard rock mining is an entirely different game.
Yeah, this ain't placer. This is coming out of the mountain.
Over a billion years ago, quartz veins containing gold were forced up from deep within the earth, forming the Marudi Motherlode. Now, local miners are digging more than 150 meters underground to chase the gold-rich seams.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
I'm Parker.
I'm George.
George, nice to meet you.
Rick.
Do you work here?
Yeah.
How old are you?
24.
Same age as you, Parker.
And are you like in a tunnel up there?
Yeah. You guys want to take a peek?
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Sweet.
Cool.
Is that as far as it is?
No.
How far does it go?
300-400 feet.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. And you've done it all by hand?
Chisel and hammer.
Manually.
Oh,
you have to go down, man. You have to go down. No,
this tunnel?
I'm not built for that. I wouldn't want to go in a hole.
I mean, that I'm not going in any tunnels.
You would go?
Yeah, I would go.
You sure?
To reach the gold seam.
Take you guys downstairs.
Parker and Sam push through a network of hand-dug tunnels, 60 meters underground.
Holy bats everywhere.
A lot of bats.
More than 100 miners have died in the tunnels of Marudi. Many remain lost in unmarked tombs.
Jeez.
That's my dad there.
Your dad?
My dad, yeah.
Hi. How are you doing? I'm Parker. We're just having a look around. Wow, this is crazy. There's 500 feet of tunnel here. It was all done by hand. This is their bracing. Right. How is that held in this rock? Just sat there?
Yeah.
Wow. The effort these guys have put in to find gold is unbelievable.
George, how long have you been working down here?
12 years, man. 12 years since I've been a kid.
And you're 24? So you've been doing this since you were 12 years old?
Yeah.
Wow.
This is all I know.
So what, you follow the rocks?
We really follow veins. Veins within the rocks. When you follow the vein, really go there.
So like that there, you would have chased it until it ran out?
Yeah, it ran out, yeah.
With a chisel and a hammer?
Cool and steady, so you don't get no big vibration and all that.
Right.
Crumble on you, no, collapse.
Has anybody died in here?
A couple of times, but it depends on how you work it. If you don't structure your place properly,
right,
then it will collapse on you.
Yeah, because you look up above and there's some, you know, there's some boulders up there.
That's a widowmaker.
Yeah. Definitely not a safe job.
So you've been anywhere like this before?
Yeah, no, I've never been anywhere like this before. And it is unbelievable. Like I just can't believe this was all done by hand. It's something that, you know, in North America hasn't been done for 100 years. These guys are hardcore. And they're putting, you know, their lives on the line every time they're in here, really. Even if they play it cool. Even if you guys play it cool, you've got a big pair of cojones to do this. Rick, it's definitely not built for guys of your size.
Yeah, that's why I'm happy to stay on the surface.
Like I said, I'm not going in any tunnels.
It's not safe. I'm not willing to put my life on the line.
Yeah. I think we can safely rule out us doing any sort of tunneling in the next 2 weeks.
Yeah.
In fact, I'm going to get off this mountain before it crumbles. Where are you guys heading?
Let's work for the day.
So this came out of your tunnel?
Watchman.
That's the watchman.
That's the watchman. What does that mean?
Bring you luck.
Very cool.
You know, that guy would have had to pull a piece of gold that he couldn't even lift up to get me in one of those tunnels.
No, it was really nice to meet you guys. Thanks for showing us around. You know, I've got nothing but respect for what you guys do, and, you know, I guess just be careful. Thanks, George.
They are some hard over here doing what they do, man. Tough.
Tough. Yeah, this is all pretty mind-blowing. Growing up with my grandpa at Big Nugget Mine, and we would find the old miners' chisels and hammers that had been hit against so many rocks that they're mushroom. That was from 1899. Yeah. And that's exactly what these guys are doing.
You read about those kind of things, you might watch a documentary about those kind of things, but actually meeting those guys and talking to them and seeing what they do is insane. And seeing what they've normalized, like they've normalized a very, very dangerous thing. And, you know, it just hit home for me because I don't know, I saw a lot of myself in George. You know, I was mining when I was 10, 12 years old. He was mining when he was 10, 12 years old. But, you know, he's in Guyana at the bottom of a tunnel at 12 years old. And George, if you're watching this, don't die in there.